Hey guys, and I'm back here again with another review, but sorry I've been gone for a little while. I know it's only been about a week, but I usually upload like 2 videos a week, but I've been really, really busy with school lately, and there's just a lot of stuff I had to do. But I'm almost done now, finals are almost over, and I could spend more time on YouTube again. But today I want to do a totally unscripted review of the Rocket Skates R10, because I did have a lot of time with the Rocket Skates and I have a bunch of thoughts about it, and I didn't think I needed to script anything. This is going to be totally unscripted and everything is going to be my thoughts as I'm thinking about my experiences with the Rocket Skates R10. And just my first impressions of it, it has a lot of potential, but it's definitely not where it should be. And if you guys want to see me fail at the Rocket Skates, I did a video called me trying out the Rocket Skates for the first time, and it is pretty hard to learn at first. And if you guys want to see me fail with a couple of my friends, make sure to go check the link down below and you guys could go check out that video. But this is the review of the Rocket Skates R10, and I think I've had enough time to finally share my thoughts of the Rocket Skates, and I'm kind of in the middle of positive and negative. I don't know if I should recommend this product or not, because it does have a lot of potential. I mean, these things could be pretty big and they could be fun if they fix some of the problems that they have with this model of the Rocket Skates. I do believe that they fix some of the problems with these Rocket Skates in their new model, the R6, I believe, and that one has a remote, which I do believe would make these things a lot better. But this product that I have right now are the R10s, and they are totally controlled by your feet and they have no remote whatsoever, and you have to just sync them up with the app that they provide. But first I want to talk about the design of the Rocket Skates itself and focus on riding it and all that stuff later. But the design of the Rocket Skates is not that bad. I mean, it does feel pretty good. It feels solid, and they are really, really heavy, and that's really the main problem with these things. They're super heavy and carrying them around is just not that practical, because they're so heavy that they feel like weights, and I feel like I could work out with these things. They're that heavy, and especially walking with them, they just really are weighing down on my feet and on my legs, and it's just really tiring to walk on them and ride on them, and they're just way too heavy and they really need to slim down the weight in order for these to be a consumer product, because I don't think a lot of people are gonna like that these are very heavy, and they might fix that with future products, but for this one, they're just way too heavy. The design, I mean, there's nothing really wrong with it. I do like how it looks, and the lights are a really good touch to the Rocket Skates, but they're just way too dang heavy and they need to slim it down, and that's pretty much the main problem with the design. And as you can see here, here is one of the Rocket Skates, and this is probably, I'd say, like about like close to 5 pounds or maybe more, but these things seriously are heavy, way too heavy to be practical, and they're also not as comfortable as I would like. Your heel is kind of locked in this thing, and you have to keep it super tight in order for you to even use this, so it just really is uncomfortable. They're heavy and they just need to fix that in order for these to be a popular product. And yeah, and I know you guys might be thinking I might be bagging on the Rocket Skates a little bit too much, but I do want to say I will always give my honest opinion on products, no matter if I get it for free or no matter if I bought it myself. And I did not buy these Rocket Skates myself. They were sent to me for review. I do have to return them, but they were sent to me for free to try out. And I am gonna give my honest opinion on it, because I do believe that I should show you guys what I really think about a product, so you could see if you should buy it or not. And the Rocket Skates R10, I just don't think you should purchase it unless you really do have the money, because it's just not practical. The problems just really outweigh the value of the product, and I would rather go for something like the Boosted Board, the Ego Board, or you know, something else, a new computer. You know, the Rocket Skates are just there's just a lot of problems with it, and I do think they have a lot of potential though. But moving on, I want to talk about the app. That was another problem with the Rocket Skates. Connecting to these rocket skates seemed almost impossible. I might be over-exaggerating a little bit, but it felt like it was impossible because whenever I would try to connect it to my phone, it just wouldn't recognize the rocket skates for some reason. It just wouldn't show up the app just wouldn't recognize the rocket skates sometimes, and it would disconnect even if I was riding it and they were already connected. They would sometimes disconnect and one of the shoes would disconnect, and then it would just cause us to stumble and stuff like that. And it just really isn't safe if this thing doesn't stay connected to your phone. It was already in my pocket and I kept it with me close to the rocket skates, but it would still disconnect. And I really do think that it's a huge problem, especially since you're going fairly fast with these things if you're going on pro mode. And if they disconnect, some of the shoes will just stop and then you'll stumble and you'll fall like we did in the video.
Oh, fuck. Oh. You have to go on your tippy toes. No.
But it's just a huge problem that they need to fix. And hopefully with the remote in the Rocket Skates R6 that I will be trying out, hopefully they fix the problem. And right now, it's just not looking good for the Rocket Skates. But I do think that's enough negatives for one video. I've been bagging on the Rocket Skates for this whole time, but I kind of want to talk about the positives I've had with the Rocket Skates. Once again, I do believe they have the potential to be a great product. They just need to fix the problems, and hopefully Acton sees this video and other reviews of the Rocket Skates and implements them into the next version of these Rocket Skates in order to improve the product. And I haven't tried the Rocket Skates Arch 6 yet, so I will be trying those out after I send these back, hopefully. But for now, the Rocket Skates are just not worth it, in my opinion. But one thing I did see with some other reviewers out there is that they didn't have fun with the Rocket Skates, and I could see why. But for me and a couple of my friends, it was actually kind of fun, learning how to ride it, because it was just really funny to see people ride this because it was just so hard to ride that it was fun, you know, to see that. And, you know, riding it was also kind of fun as well, you know, when you got it down. But, you know, it just, the problems just really outweigh the value of this product. And hopefully Acton will improve with their next product, and hopefully I will have a different opinion on the Rocket Skates R6. And that's basically all my thoughts on the Rocket Skates R10, and this was my unscripted, honest review, and hopefully you guys liked it. If you did, make sure to leave a like down below. As always, I'll see you guys in the next one.